As far as the issue of vote buying is concerned, meron na po, may 40 hindi makatiis, hindi makahintay ng tamang panahon. October 19 pa dapat ang campaign period up to 28. Mga iba dyan, namimili na, umiikot na, nagpaparaffle pa. So we will be filing at least 40 cases pa rin. And we will disqualify, we will prove to them that the COMELEC is not just making a show para lang sa public consumption. No, we will be very serious because we would like to set a standard that if that pwede naman palang gawin ng komisyon, bakit hindi natin nagagawa in the past? At number two, para sa 2025 and the succeeding electoral exercises, then this will now be the basis. Ginawa natin ng barangay SK. Why can't we not do that in the national and local elections?
Okay. Now, meron na po bang ano, BSKE areas of concern?
Yes, ma'am. We have 246 areas under red category. Maybe this afternoon, the commission, after our end bank this morning, will be able to release 246 po, ma'am, yan. But barangays, we did not classify the areas of concern, yung red categories, na mga municipalities. It's unfair on the other barangays belonging to that municipality. We merely categorize the barangays as red, green, orange, or yellow. But in the meantime, we have 246. And we place the entire province of Negros Oriental under COMELEC control and kindly monitor in the next few days whether the COMELEC will be placing pa other places in our country under COMELEC control.
Okay, now why did Negros Oriental have to be under COMELEC control?
Simply because, you know what, even if Ma'am Karen, the incident happened in March of 2023, the fear in the minds and hearts of our people in Negros are still there. And we are fully aware of that. And in order to prevent any possible violence that might occur simply because baka mag-spill over pa yung nangyari nung March, then there should be a quick reaction on the part of the commission election. Again, this is a guarantee from your COMELEC. We will not interfere on your ordinary lives. We will not disturb the status quo. We will not even interfere on the local government function and powers. But anytime that there is a need for the COMELEC to act, we will act fast and swiftly.
Okay. Now, I know over 1.4 million people filed their candidacies for the barangay and SK elections. And let's go back just to how much they should be spending. I was told recently that you have barangay chairman that are spending 12 million, 14 million pesos.
It's really unfortunate. And if that is true, we will file cases against them. It should only be 5 pesos. Again, 5 pesos per registered voter and the competition.
So technically, mga magkano yun? Ma'am, per barangay chair?
Kung may 2,000 voters ka lang, times 5 pesos, that's only 10,000 pesos.
During the campaign period. Chairman naman, pero is that realistic? That's alam naman natin, lahat walang nagte-10,000 sa kampanya.
That's the reason why, Ma'am Karen, we had been pushing our legislature to pass the law. Kasi po, 30 years ago na po yun, yung 3 pesos, 5 pesos, 10 pesos sa president. Sana medyo i-adjust naman po. And I honestly believe na si Senator Aimee Marcos already filed a bill and now to be debated in the plenary, increasing the amount. Kasi ma'am, wala naman po talaga magsasabi. Let's face it, na ang ginastos lang nila 10,000 pesos. Isang araw lang po yung 10,000 pesos sa reality natin.
Hindi ka na ata makabili ng poster lang doon sa 10,000.
Correct. Pero seriously po, pati sa mga kababayan natin na mga tumatakbo, pati po sa mga botante, magkakakilala na po kayo. Why need to spend that much? Magkakakilala, magkakamag-anak po kayo, magkakaibigan, magkakapit-bahay. Come to think of isang barangay, ang liit-liit po niya, ilang sityo lang po yan eh. And so why spend so much? And therefore,
so why do you think, that's a good question, why do you think do they end up spending 12 million?
Because they are not popular. They will not be voted upon by the people. Kung kilala ka ng tao,
but where does the 12 million go?
To the people, ma'am, because yung iba dyan, umuuwi ng probinsya. Para
so that would be bribery.
That would be vote buying. Dapat pa nga bribery pa po yun eh. But we have to understand also that vote buying, it takes two to tango. There should be vote buyer and vote seller at the same time. So warning din po yan sa mga kababayan natin. If we are going to charge the vote buyers, then we are going to charge the vote sellers. But don't be afraid to report because we can always exclude from prosecution anybody who will report to us. And we can place anybody under Witness Protection Program.
Okay, so do you have confidential funds? I'm curious.
No,
I know
ma'am.
That you're You're kidding.
Wala po, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Actually po, kung
but do you
talaga,
need confidential funds?
Kung tutuusin talaga, ma'am Karen, dapat ang meron ng COMELEC. Kasi po, ang dami namin iniimbestigahan.
Eh, ba't di kayo humingi kung ano-anong agensya ang nabigyan ng confidential funds
madami
na hindi naman kailangan?
Dami na pong marites dito sa amin sa COMELEC. Tama na po yung mga marites namin para magbigay sa amin ng mga informations.
Oh, but wait, let's remind the public, an issue you had was you actually requested. Was it, am I correct, for 4 billion, our last interview, and then you were only given 2 billion? Tama ba?
Yes, ma'am. For the barangay and SK elections, kasi po talaga, nag-increase ang voters natin from, naging ano na po tayo ngayon, 92 million ang voters na po natin, barangay and SK. And so originally from 89 million, like 92 million. And so,
yeah,
the increase in the number of voters, increase in the expenditures, but we were only given 2. But just the same, ma'am, okay na po yun. We can do with that so long as we are able to protect our votes and at the same time to ensure that the voters are able to vote.
Okay. Now, just for the record, we are using Smartmatic, this barangay and SK elections.
No, ma'am. It's a manual elections. And
manual to.
Manual elections. And therefore, we are going to write the names of the candidates and we are going to manually count the votes at the end of the voting.
Okay, so let's give our viewers an overview. There are 42,000 seats for barangay chairperson, 294,000 plus members for Sangguniang Barangay, and you have Sangguniang Kabataan, 42,000 seats plus. Okay, let's focus on Taguig and Makati. Paano na to ngayon? So the Supreme Court decided how many barangays are now moved to Taguig?
10 barangays, Ma'am Karen.
10.
And we have to make a decision before the filing of the candidacy. It's a make or break decision. The question in our minds at that time was that saan tayo magpapafile ng certificates of candidacy? It's very symbolic. When you file the COC in Makati, then Makati will say, yeah, we still retain jurisdiction. When we file the candidacy in Taguig, then Taguig will say, of course, that, well, that's what the decision of the Supreme Court says. The COMELEC decided to require the filing of the candidacy in Taguig at the time of the filing in August 28 to September 2, Ma'am Karen. That is a recognition not of the jurisdiction of the city, but we recognize merely the decision of the Supreme Court. At that time, there was this decision, and we are fully aware of the boundaries because we asked the Regional Trial Court of Pasig for the decision, and in that decision, nandun po kasi yung mga boundaries. So, na-determine namin yung 10 barangays, yung po yung nilipat namin, the EMBO barangays.
Oo. Alam mo, this is quite interesting. I mean, what? So clearly, all the barangay people, the barangay chairman, the Sangguniang, they live mismo in the EMBO area, correct?
Yes,
for you to be able to run. But now, they will be considered as a barangay chairman of Taguig or SK of Taguig if they win.
Yes, they are now considered number one residents of Taguig because the 10 barangays are now part of Taguig. Number two, they will be considered as voters of Taguig. We automatically transferred their registration from Makati to Taguig. And number three, in the event that they will be winning, then they are now barangay officials and SK officials of the city of Taguig.
Oo, pero per barangay, ilan ba ang Sangguniang Kabataan na pwedeng tumakbo ngayon?
Kasama, ma'am, yung barangay, depende po kasi, pero kasama po yung 7 po lahat sila. Kasama
7.
Po yung SK. We, as you correctly pointed out earlier, we have 762,000 positions to be filled up in the entire country.
Oo. At yung SK na yon dapat nakatira rin yon sa barangay na yon.
Yes, ma'am. They should be residents of these barangays. And since ngayon po, voters sila ng barangays na ito, automatically, because of the action of the commission, automatically they are now registered voters and residents of these barangays.
Uh-oh. Do you remember how many residents are covered by these 10 EMBO barangays?
That almost were 302,000 voters, Ma'am Karen.
Uh-oh. So 302,000, we add... That would be maybe times 3 because not all are voters. So there are like over 2 million constituents.
Mga 2 million constituents po yon affected by the transfer of these 10 barangays from Makati to Taguig.
And how many more positions have now been opened to Taguig? So you have the chairperson, 7 Sangguniang Kabataan, yung Sangguniang Barangay, ilan all in all? So isang butuhan.
10 po yung barangay chairman, tapos meron siyang mga, sabihin na natin, 7 na mga kagawad. So, at, so lahat yan, 10 plus, so mga ano po, siguro mga 500 positions, 560 oh. positions.
560 positions have now been open to Taguig.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, and will there be an issue there? Are you seeing something different or it's just a change of label?
Yeah, of course, there it's more political than what than legal. That of course, Taguig will now have to allocate funds for these 10 barangays, including funding for the new barangay chairperson and the SK. So mag-allocate po sila ng pondo para sa kanila. And of course, ma'am, yung mga benefits na bibigay din po sa mga residents or constituents na na-transfer from Makati to Taguig.
Okay. And any other, I know that the filing of the COC, of course, tapos na to.
Yes, ma'am. We tapos na po tayo. It's very, very peaceful. And of course, the campaign will start by August 19 to 28. We are monitoring what is happening in Socorro, in Surigao del Norte, ma'am. And so far, there is no, whatever issues that there are in Socorro has no effect whatsoever with our preparation.
Yeah.
There is no a free flowing of people.
Yeah. But I wanted to ask you that Socorro, the SBSI, I mean, I saw the drone footage and it was quite a large community over there. Are they considered one barangay?
No, ma'am. They're just part of two sitios inside a barangay. Okay. In fact, there is no polling place or polling precinct inside the compound. They will have to walk about 3 to 4 kilometers at least. They will have to go down to the poblacion to vote as part of the of that particular barangay. Wala po sa taas. Wala po sa taas na polling place.
Oo, walang butuhan doon.
Wala po. We are fully
aware. Walang sariling barangay chairman doon.
Wala naman po, ma'am. But and that's why, ma'am, I went there last week to ensure that at least people are able to campaign. That should be guaranteed. And number two, that people are able to vote on election day without any violence or without any hesitation.
Okay. All right. Anything you'd like to add, Chairman?
This is just a request to our voters. Please don't vote to those who are violating our laws, to those who at least this early are not following the rules and regulations of the Commission of Election. Wala pong bibigay na maayos yung mga yan at wala pong paglilingkod na magiging maayos din kasi ngayon pa lamang violators na sila. Just try to look for somebody who at this point are showing that they are law-abiding citizens. Pag law-abiding, ibig sabihin, magiging maayos and they will implement the laws to the fullest.
All right. On that note, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia, thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Karen. Thank you very much for the program.
Okay.